An area of 21.6 square kilometers or 8.34 square miles was just incinerated by pyroclastic flows, where what was beforehand pristine forest now has petrified lifeless trunks standing in their place. While what I just described is the maximum estimate of the damage caused by yesterday's major volcanic eruption of a Lewotobi volcano, I am fairly confident that a figure of at least 70% this size represents a lower bound. And while it is difficult to predict what might happen next, another highly explosive eruption of a similar magnitude, probably in the next 2 to 6 days, is in my opinion considered as more likely to occur than to not happen. In other words, evacuations need to remain in place and the current threat is not over. The 53,000 foot or 16,154 meter high eruption plume yesterday caused multiple flight cancellations specifically on the island of Bali due to this high level plume drifting over and slightly south of the island. In fact, there may be additional flight disruptions today as the plume drifts between Christmas Island and Jakarta. While it is difficult to be certain exactly how much ash fill, it appears that a minimum of 10 centimeters or 4 inches of ash fill across a 38 square mile region, creating this distinctively gray coloration seen from the satellite. As a quick reference, this is how it looked beforehand representing a baseline image, while this image shows thermal signatures from northward trending pyroclastic flows that struck. These pyroclastic flows scorched new areas of forest that had been untouched by the three large November 2024 eruptions from the same volcano, covering a larger area than at least two of, possibly all three of the pyroclastic flows produced by the 2024 eruptions. Of particular note was the fact that the largest new burned area is to the north-northeast of the erupting Laki-Laki cone, straddling both sides of its lengthy January 2024 lava flow. While some hazards from this eruption were more significant than its counterparts, others were less significant. However, with our new information, it truly does appear that the March 20th eruption was the largest by tephra volume of the group, marking this volcano's largest explosive eruption in recorded history. The initial mushroom cloud it generated during its peak eruptive phase was quite large, measuring somewhere between 49 and 65 kilometers wide. For a quick comparison, the very upper end of this range, as I am still verifying initial data and removing noise, would be about the same mushroom cloud size as the one produced by the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Falling lapilli, or volcanic ejecta measuring 2 to 64 millimeters wide, was reported to have fallen as much as 40 kilometers to the west during this low-end VEI-3 explosive eruption. At the present, Lewotobi is only producing a weaker 10,000 foot or 3,048 meter high eruptive plume, but this weaker activity is not likely to last. Right now, Lewotobi's summit vicinity seemingly has two weak points. We first have the initial fissure associated with the early stages of its 2023 to present eruption, which is vigorously degassing at the present and could as a vent reactivate. The second spot is directly west of its summit, where its November 2024 lava flow traveled. The latest eruption blew apart a portion of the crater wall, creating a new ravine there which is 35 meters or 115 feet deep. The main problem is that both of these areas represent areas of the volcano which have signs of structural instability that could lead to landslides or even a lateral blast which could reasonably harm areas outside of the current exclusion zone. While there is no obvious precursor like there was at 1980 Mount St. Helens, I would feel irresponsible not mentioning this unlikely, albeit potential, outcome. Only time will tell what will happen next, but based on the continuing high level of earthquakes, another major eruption is likely in the next week.